So my name's Ali. I was born and raised in Pakistan. I've been living in Brussels for the past 6 years. In the beginning, I didn't like it, but then I got used to it. What I do is organized events where people come together and launch startups for inside the company and outside. Because I believe in one thing, that we all have the power to change the world, and not in a cliched way. The quote over there is asking you, when was the last time you tried to do something that could help impact society in a positive way? My way of saying that it used to be the case that you needed a lot of money to set up a factory, to supply stuff into the economy, to be able to have an impact. That was the industrial age for the past 150 years. Our education system, our pension system, our social security system, our tax system, our whole society was organized to create individuals who could fit into the industrial mindset and the corporation and produce value like that. Now, all of that has changed. All of that has changed with the advent of mass communication, digital media, and social media, to the extent that you, me, anybody can now reach consumers and like-minded people all across the globe. But not enough of us are doing that. Not enough of us are making an impact. And the reason for that, I think, is that as a society, we're still, the majority of us are living in the industrial age. Peter Drucker came up in one of the past talks. One of his most impactful quotes is, the most dangerous thing in times of turbulence is not the turbulence. It's using yesterday's logic. In my work, I travel across and coach teams and organizations as well. And one of the major reasons that comes up when I ask the question, why did you fail, is either I didn't have the right people, or I didn't have enough time, or I didn't have enough resources, primarily money, right? But we all know, looking at history, that the people who've made the most impact on the positive and negative side, the Hitlers and Saddam Husseins of the world, the Henry Fords and Obamas of the world, and the Mandelas of the world, they all started with claims to all three. No time, because they had to work for survival, no money, no resources. But they ended up making the most impact, because they, instead of looking at wanting resources, they concentrated on resourcefulness. So what I do is, very quickly, organize events where people come together. I believe in the power of connection. Whatever, and I have a crazy team to work with, whatever you, me, everybody need in dreams and goals, the ingredients for those are out there somewhere in the world with somebody. The reason you activate that somebody to collaborate with you is to stand up and announce what you want. So I organize events where people can do that, basically. Pitch ideas on how they want to start a new product or service or anything in their local economy to impact the community around. We've done the first ever when it comes to hardware entrepreneurship, maker movement, that's been brought into Brussels. We've done the first ever when it comes to financial technology, fintech innovation last year. We've done a first ever fashtech, fashion and technology event in Antwerp last year, where people simply come up, pitch ideas to a group of 100 plus individuals. They then have the choice to select the top 10 ideas by public voting. All right, teams organically form around those ideas and start working overnight. On Saturday, they get coaching. It's a weekend format. There you see the pitching and selection happening. Teams form around those ideas. They go through coaching. They journey from having an idea to having a working business model by Sunday night, where they present to a panel of jury and get potential networks, first customers, potential investment, and they're on the way. Life can change and evolve from there. And we have interesting events coming up that you'll see later on as well about educational innovation. I mentioned in my introduction that society is structured, and one of the major ways that that structure is held in place is through the education system that produces people who can fit into the industrial economic system rather than people who can go out and have creative ideas. Creativity is such labor, whereas it comes naturally to kids. Whoever has seen a depressed kid or a non-creative kid. Kids always try to put things together in a new way, but we get structured down into thinking in boxes. To the extent that we now have to disrupt the education system for us to have that freshness and aliveness available to us again. So we're doing an event on that. It's in Leuven, the student town, like the you know, the Hallmark student town in Belgium. That's in April. We're collaborating with the big educational institutions over. This is a shout out for anybody who wants to collaborate, participate, provide, be coach or mentors, or have, if you in your network know people who are active on the educational innovation front. The other topic is about food innovation. We're doing that in Ghent in May this year. And we have three major themes for that. Food sustainability, something that's very important. How much food gets wasted? If I share the numbers with you, you'll actually be surprised. We waste so much more. I think 1/3 of all the food that's produced goes to waste. Imagine how many people you could feed with that. The second aspect is experience. Eating combined with other sensory experiences is actually a very pleasurable part of existing as a physical being with five senses. So we're going to be concentrating on how to innovate to have more food experiences available to people. And the third part is about health and nutrition. You literally become what you eat. We are miracle-making machines, our body, because if I eat a banana and if she eats a banana, it's the same banana. But over here, the banana becomes a male body, and over there, it becomes a female body. But it's the same banana. And we are sitting with these beautiful miracle-making machines, and we're putting in junk. I am probably projecting what I'm doing. But we're going to have a conversation about how to innovate on that. So that's my shout-out. Two new events on the horizon. You all know the reason we're doing it. If you have anything to share, let's come up and talk after the session, and let's have some drinks together now. Thank you so much.